Thank you. I can see you're not all that old, are you? The Beatles signed Badfinger, it was on the Apple label, the band was, and McCartney said, you really need a song to kickstart the band's career. I got one. It's going to be in a film called The Magic Christian, with all sorts of luminaries in it, you know, people like Ringo Starr, Peter Sellers and so on. He said, if you do this song, it will be a hit for you. And thank God he was right. It's called Come and Get It.
Slight change of pace again. One of the great styles of music from the sort of 60s was the sound of Tamla Motown. This particular song was
when I know she was pretty. Ooh, yes, she was. She was a gorgeous little girl, the prettiest thing in the whole damn world. She was pretty. Ooh. She was. She was pretty. Ooh, yes, she was.
Again, and this is a hit for the band in 1971. Seems like yesterday. I remember having hair at the time. Anyway, and I was nearly good looking in those days. But this record got to number 6 in the charts. See if you remember it. It's called Freedom Come, Freedom Go. So it was called Bad to Me. Here we go. If you ever leave me, I'll be sad and blue. Don't you ever leave me, I'm so in love with you. Things are on a little bit and go more into the country music.
She's so fine. No one knew she's gonna be mine.
Mr. Michael Smitham. Now, ladies and gentlemen, my past, one of the bands I was in, being in the Fortunes, please welcome, from all sorts of bands, Mr. Glenn Taylor.
Hello, good afternoon, everybody. You enjoying yourselves so far? Well, we shouldn't change that. Anyway, like Ed says, we've all been round the block, and I've been in a couple of other bands, one that's not all that far from here. Do you remember a band called The Marmalade? I was in that band for many, many years. Another band called The Love Affair, you must remember them, Everlasting Love from that business. I was there as well. Anyway, we're going to do a Marmalade song. This was recorded in 1976. It got to number 7 in the charts, something like that. I hope you enjoy our version of From the Pot, It Seems. Thank you.
Mr. Glenn Taylor, come on.
Big hand for Glenn.
Come on.
The stage, ladies and gentlemen, the guy on the keyboards here, as well as being in the Fortunes, was also a member in the 70s and still does concerts today as a member of a rock band, one or two of you might have heard of. They were called Badfinger. Anybody remember Badfinger? Please welcome on keyboards Mr. Bob Jackson.
Thank you both. Yeah, thanks very much. Right, we want to play you a song now that this is a bit of a ballad. And it's a song that you really are going to know. It's one of the biggest hits, I think, one of the biggest ballads of all time. And people tend to attribute it to a guy called Harry Nilsson, if you remember. Harry, do you remember him? Great talent. He had a huge hit with this song in the 70s. And then when they re-released it, he had another big hit in the 80s, another number one. And since him, of course, so many people have had big, big success with the song. So all that remains really is to just point out that although he had a fantastic pedigree as a writer, Harry didn't write this one. He wrote lots of great songs, but he didn't write this one. This is a Badfinger song. It means so much to me. Hope it might connect with you as well.
Well, I can't forget this evening, all your faces you were leaving, but I guess that's just the way the story goes. You always smile, but in your eyes, your sorrow shows. Yes, it shows.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Storm the Tickle Bicket, for the band back in the 70s. Now, obviously, when you get to our sort of time of life, you've been round the block a bit. Have you all been round the block?
TV. It was a music-based quiz show. Do you remember it? It was called Name That... Yeah. Name That Tune. And if you remember the format of the show, they used to play the contestants a number of notes, a sequence of notes, and people would try and guess what the tune might be. And sometimes, of course, they'd play 9 or 10 notes, and they'd battle it down, and in the end it might be just 3 or 4 notes. Thought we could give it a go. What do you think? Okay, I'm going to give you one note. Just the one. But you're clever people, aren't you? You'll get it. You'll be surprised you will actually get it. What is this very, very famous song? What's this one? Not that one. This one.
Rubbish, rubbish.
You're my world, you're the show. Actually got us some very exotic places. About a couple of years ago, we went and we did a Caribbean cruise. It was much better than that. We also went to, we did 14 days in Canada. We
getting better. And then we ended up in Las Vegas. Now you're bloody impressed, aren't you? All because this was a big hit over there. Have a listen, see if you remember this one.
Feeling a big hit in America for the band. Now, this next song was originally a hit for two guys called the Everly Brothers, and we recorded a version of it a few years ago.
Ooh.
Thank you very much, and good afternoon.
Thank you.
For us musicians, this is the middle of the night. We don't normally get up this early. It's wonderful to be back up here in Cumberland. Is that the right one? Or Westmore, one of them. I'm an Irishman, I know nothing. Now listen, ladies and gentlemen, that was Here It Comes Again, a big hit for the band. If you don't know the Fortunes, that was a top five hit in the 60s. This next song was a big hit for a lady singer called Dusty Springfield. It was a great song written by great songwriters of the time, Burt Bacharach and Hal David. It's called I Just Don't Know What to Do With Myself.